Hi, I'm Colby Perry, and welcome to the 2023 episode of Stafford Report.
This year, we're doing something different. We're bringing you content we like. Not some fake news or even real news. Not news.
We're bringing you content that we like, and we really hope that you will like as well. First up, we have Mason Bushy's Weird Questions, a segment where Mason Bushy asks people... First up, we have Mason Bushy's Weird Questions, a segment where Mason Bushy asks people he may or may not know weird questions.
Weird Questions with Mason.
Welcome to Weird Questions with Mason, where I ask people that I may or may not know weird questions. So today's question, first of all, who am I here with?
Hello, I'm Bryce Connaughton in the engineering department.
So today's question is, how do you like my glasses?
Quite beautiful. I love them a lot.
Thank you. No, ready? Watch this. Okay. So I'm back with question of the day. I'm here with
Thomas
and
Dominic.
Okay. So today's question is, how do you like my glasses?
You're wearing glasses?
Very stylish and brown.
Thank you. Thanks, guys. I'm Mason. I'm back with Weird Questions. Who am I here with?
Nate.
That's Nate. Today's...
Okay.
Today's question is, if you were to kill an elephant, how many chickens would be required?
I'm 112.
Thank you. So, who am I here with?
Max Petrosi.
Okay. And today's question is, if you were to kill an elephant, how many chickens would be required?
One.
Is that it?
Take the bones and you just shank it to death.
Okay, thank you.
Weird Questions with Mason!
Now to Artistically Incapable, a show where people can't make art.
My name is Ash Kennett, and welcome to Artistically Incapable, where people have to draw me because they're bad at art.
Artistically Incapable.
This is Gabe Stickney.
I'm the one who's bad at art.
Alright. Draw me.
I'm gonna try my best. You have defining facial features of... White. So we already have the main color. Forehead. You don't even have a straight hairline. Why did I do that? You have like a more of like a... Because of that. You look like a JoJo character. You do. In this, you do. You kind of look like a... Who's the guy with the pompadour? Speak, man! Speak! Who's the man... Who's the guy with the pompadour?
Polmarov.
Thank you. Okay, I made your hairline too short now. What? It's fine. Making... You look...
He looks like Bobby Hill.
He does. Okay. I have to like, I don't know, do that. You know what? I'm gonna give him that hair in the back.
And this is Frieza, if he was a JoJo villain.
Artistically incapable.
This is my time for him to, draw me. He's gonna draw me.
The master has become the artist.
Yes. I'm already offended. Oh no. Oh.
You're blind.
Oh my god, I look like an Avatar character.
You look like a messed up killer queen. This is Gabe Stickney as a mafia man.
Wait, you're forgetting one key feature of me.
The unibrow.
I have a unibrow? Get in there, there's not a single hair right there. I'm proud of that. Anyways, that is me, obviously.
I don't know.
And that is a buffoon. That is an idiot.
One of the things I'm like,
okay.
To be fair, this is not me either. This is Frieza as a JoJo villain.
I don't know. I see.
This is the Frieza JoJo anime girl, and that's a mafia boss.
This is a stroke.
That's a Mexican mafia boss.
Oh God.
Artistic Elan incapable.
Lights, camera, action.
That was some of the videos that we've been working on over the last month in video. Do you want to be a part of it? Here's a video commercial that we've done here in our program.
Lights, camera, action. Explore your imagination creating short films, skits, and commercials. You can get certified in Premiere, After Effects, and more. You can get hands-on work in the classroom and out in the field with our broadcast mobile setup and our top-of-the-line cameras. Create, critique, and communicate. Come to Video Communications.
For more information, you can go to staffordonline.org.
Next up, we have a video that Colby Perry created for his first video project of the year. And now, enjoy the fight scene.
Next up, we have a duo of indie films produced by Ash Kennett. You can find both of them and more.
What are you doing on my land? Why is it fat on his front when he's here? Oh God, Lucian! What?
Christ, where is he? No, you can't do this to me.
I was still.
Oh yes, I can. Spatula, come and attack us.
Oh, it's just such a wonderful day.
Well, it isn't another opponent. On guard, loser!
What? Who are you? What are you doing here?
You can call me Sin Gnome!
Well, Mr. Gnome, I challenge you to a duel.
Oh my gnome! I forgot my wand!
I couldn't stand without my wand! I'll kill that man. That gnome.
What is this? Is it a wand? Oh, John Little, I challenge you. Do a duel.
How do you know my name, Mr. Gnome?
Because I know who I'm going to kill before I kill them. You're nothing but a crazy crack addict. Hi-ya! I shall be the victor. You have lost, John Little. Now die with honor.
John Little, I honor you in death as the greatest opponent I've ever faced. I will fight you again in hell!
Now, I own new land. You may just call me the Gnome.
Here's another segment by me based on a color theory project we did in class.
Beautiful day, huh?
If you like video games, you will like this next one.
So, spawning goes as followed. You just get the Moody grapple shot, which is by the NPC at the Smoldering Cave, and you pull the blazes towards you in the stronghold if you have less equated gear. I have decent gear. As you can see, I have decent weapons. The equipment is relatively decent. My armor is going to be shown so you know what I have ranged for this. This is rather high-end gear. You do not require this to do this, but if you spawn it at the Smoldering Cave, by pulling a blaze up to the top, there's a rock with a 1x1 behind it, right here, that you can pull the blade into and kill. I have slot binding, so I swapped my keys rather fast, but placing an overflux and using the two daggers as seen, you can go through it, and upon arriving in the first demon phase, you should push the mobs into the wall, but that one bugged out. So what you would do is avoid the beams and punch it into the wall slightly till it suffocates, and then continue killing the pigman. And it takes a while to die, but when you kill the pigman, make sure that you are relatively close to the boss, just not teleport out. And the second demon's phase will be made a little differently, but still rather easily. And as you saw there, the fire pillars, most of them are disabled, although they do still spawn, so keep your eyes out. I'm not responsible for any deaths. Fire pit will spawn there. It'll die first. I messed up there. But you go in, I would recommend going to first person mode for this. You will have to hit the pigman demon first to let that hit its phase to suffocate the skeleton demon. And then using the sword of bad health gives you that little bit of extra strength. And as you exit this demon phase, you would want to swap to the other side of the other hit pit, because there are fire pits that will spawn there. And I'm fumbling a little bit, but there you go.
Now, here's an interview with the co-owner of an up-and-coming store in the town of Fairhaven, Goblin Games.
Hello, my name is Dylan Blackmer, and I am one of the four owners of a new shop called Goblin Games. What really inspired me to open the store is, I've always loved being able to play card games and stuff like that. And collecting stuff is one of my hobbies. And it came to me that there is no nearby store to do that. The closest one is driving all the way out to Rutland. So I thought, oh, hey, why don't me and a few of my buddies that love to play games, why don't we open a game store where kids can collect cards and just have fun and get to know each other? I want to give it that nice homey mom-and-pop feel. More or less, when you come in, you're not going to see us sit behind a register and hide there and not interact with you. The whole point is we will play games with the customers. Like, if they come in with a deck of cards and they want to play Magic or Pokemon, we'll definitely sit there and play with them. We're going to be as friendly to you as possible. We're not going to be like, oh, we're here for your money. We're going to be like, hey, here, take a seat, play some games, enjoy yourself. And we just want to be different, because every card store I've gone to, I sort of get the, oh, come here, get your games, and get out. So our store is going to, it's a retail-based store, but the main product is going to be tabletop games, card games, like some of the best ones to pick out is Magic the Gathering, Pokemon, Yu-Gi-Oh! We have Funko Pops there. You're going to see anime figures ranging all the way from, we have Sword Art Online, down to No Game, No Life, and some JoJo's Bizarre Adventures. We are planning on hosting stuff at later hours. Like, I know right now we don't have it really worked out, but every Thursday night we're gonna wanna host a D&D session, and then we're thinking maybe Friday night Magic, maybe Monday night Pokemon, and it's gonna be a lot of just coming in and hanging out and making friends with people who have stuff in common with you.
Here's a little video about dog training, created by Gabe Stickney. You may or may not learn anything from this. And there has got to be a nice jazz in the background.
Good afternoon, everyone. Yeah, welcome to Animal House. My name is Christina Kumpka. This is what it's like to have a Belgian Malinois. Typically a sheepdog, sheep herding dog actually, from Belgium. And as you can see, they are very smart, very active, quite hard to train, but we're gonna show you a little bit about what to do with these dogs and how to do it today. Okay, ready? Heel, sit. As you can see, his high drive tool is a toy. He loves a toy. So if you're not careful, they will bump you in the crotch, which is not good, or they will down on their own. So you have to keep them always focused, structured, and directed. Here, sit down. Good boy. and then the reward should always be what they want. All right, so we're going to go to the bottom of my driveway, and then I'm gonna show you how to heal your dog at the end of the driveway. The reason why it's important to train your dog to sit and stay until you release him is because, as you can see, I live on a busy road, and I do not want him to go into the busy road and get killed by a car. So anytime you want your dog to be safe, it's important to train them to stay and also to leave it when you don't want them to eat something or go after an animal. Now, as you can see, I keep saying the command, so it's firm in his mind what I want him to do, and we're gonna wait for a car to go by. Wait. Good down, good down, good down. Free! Yeah, go get it! Oh, what a good boy! So that was good, because that was a huge, loud, noisy truck, and he could have lunged at it, chased it, did whatever, but he wanted the lake more. So that's the key, repetition, encouraging them to be around the stimulus, and then not reacting or responding to the stimulus.
Next up is A Day on the Homestead with Jamal by Caden Powell.
Hi everyone, I'm Caden. This is my goat Jamal. Today I'm going to teach you how to properly feed and water goats. First, what you're going to want to do is you want to go wherever you store your feed and or hay and grab a nice healthy amount. What I like to do is I'd like to put it in this old recycling bin to help me transport it over to Jamal's hut. Makes for a lot easier transportation. Next, what you want to do is you want to get the hay and fill it up in the trough. Make sure you pack it right in there to fit as much in as possible, like this. There. Just like that, it's that easy and simple. After we do the hay, we move on to filling up his water trough. What we do is we take the hose, open it up, and spray it right in the water trough till it's full, or it cycles out some of the bad water that was still maybe in there. It's okay to lose a little bit, as it just runs off. And that's how you fill up your goat's water trough. Thank you for joining me today. This is how you properly feed and water your goats. Have an excellent day and enjoy your fun adventures with your furry little friends.
Next up is Lucas Henderson's Awesome Show by Lucas Henderson.
Oh my God! Awesome Show by Lucas Henderson.
How is your day?
I'm doing well. I'm doing good. I'm doing awesome.
What's your opinion on the glaciers in Antarctica melting and like polar bears like falling? Have you seen those videos?
That sucks. I like the, I like the Gatorade Glacier flavor, but...
Time to jam out. Let's listen to this one. What the?
You suck. Everything you do is pointless.
I can't believe it. What did I say to the bear? What did I say to the bear?
What is bro doing?
What's up, dude? That's crazy. Please, bro. He's eating stuff off my bed. What is your favorite doo-wop Kane song? That's awe-inspiring. That's awe-inspiring.
It's the end. Next up is a video of weird kids putting things in their mouths.
Hey, my name is Christina Kumpka, and I'm your host today on Gabby Blair's show called What the Hell Is This in My Mouth? Today we have two teams. We have Team Gabs,
made up of Gabby and Gabe.
Hello.
Yeah, and then we have Team Food,
made up of Lucas and Ryan.
Yeah, awesome. Today we have 10 foods. The goal of the show is to have one partner eat the food, give clues to the other partner as far as what the food may be, and then have that partner guess the correct name of the food. Each correct guess gets 1 point. Any questions? You weren't paying attention. We have blindfolds. That's what we need. Yes. Okay. We're going to get some blindfolds and we're going to get started. First mystery food is going to be tasted by Ryan, and Lucas is going to try to guess what it is.
What even is that?
Do not say what it is, but give hints to your partner as far as what it might be.
It feels like a plant.
Put it in your mouth.
What does it taste like? Don't say what it is. He's got to guess. It feels like a plant.
Tastes like this vegetable. Tastes like sweet.
Vegetable, sweet. Your clues are.
It's got
are
this leaf
texture.
Sweet vegetable leafy.
That's like lettuce.
No, wrong. 10 more seconds to guess. Give him more clues. Come on. Give him more clues.
It tastes like this papery thing.
Kind of like lettuce. No, cabbage. Wrong.
It's not that big.
Okay, 3 seconds. One. Team Food got one wrong. What is it? It was parsley.
Oh.
Parsley.
You better get me good at this.
It's something you drink. I'm gonna put it up to your lips.
No,
you're gonna take a sip.
Me too.
All right,
don't
be careful.
Don't drop it.
It's gross. Smell it first.
That is disgusting.
Hello? Can you describe it?
Give hints. Can you describe it?
Gabe, I swear to God, if we lose.
It tastes like B.O. Like a sauce, obviously.
Six.
Mayonnaise!
Five.
Ketchup, mustard.
Four.
Duck sauce.
Three.
Soy sauce, teriyaki sauce.
Two.
Barbecue sauce.
One.
Something sauce.
This is a really hard one. This was fish sauce.
Oh. Ew!
Fish sauce.
What?
Score now for Team Food is 0. For Team Gabs, 0. Next up.
Now a commercial about one of our many programs here at Stafford.
In our construction tech program, we build houses. We do projects inside in which we sell and make money for, such as Adirondack chairs, artwork.
My favorite part is definitely being able to go to the house and actually do things that you would do on a job site. It really does prepare you for the real life.
Our program is really heavy in math, which is a lot of fun. because a lot of students come to us who never really liked math or were so-so in terms of math, and we are able to use our tools and put practical applications to the math, which actually makes math a lot of fun. My goal to complete things that will make you step back and look up at what you've done and feel really proud and have a sense of closure in each step that you do. Building things is often a lot of diligent work, but when you get to the end project, it's one of the best feelings ever.
Well, folks, that's what all we have for you here today.
Join us soon for another episode of the Stafford Report.